Hello guys, and welcome to Programmerist. Today I'm gonna talk about how to avoid unnecessary errors. I'm talking about this because sometimes, instead of handling errors, the best solution is to simply avoid the errors themselves, meaning you don't need to create errors where you don't need them. Sometimes the best solution for a problem is just avoiding the problem itself. So with errors, the solution is the same. To handle errors better, you simply need to avoid them. So let's look at some examples of how we can avoid errors. So for example, we have support function remove item, okay, and receives an item. And we can do something like this. If we don't have the item, we can throw new error. Otherwise, we can delete the item. Okay, and let's imagine we have both the function has item any boolean return false, and the function deletes the item any void. Okay, so here it is the exported function, it is the public function. So what we're doing here, we're generating an error where we can avoid it. So this error here, it is, in my opinion, it is a necessary error, because what we can do here is simply return. Why can we do it? Because the result of removing an item when it doesn't exist is the same as removing the item when we succeed with removing it. So for example, after this function is called with some item and we don't have the item in our item list, in our item set, when we don't do anything, the result is that the item is not in our set of items. So you can say that the remove item did what it's supposed to do, it removed the item. So this way we are avoiding unnecessary error, and this way we don't need to handle the error or create a bug by not handling it. Another example of how we can avoid errors is by not returning nulls or undefineds. So let's look at the example. So let's imagine we have get items. Okay, and it returns an array of function, an array of items. So if we don't have items, then we will return, okay, and items will be some kind of array. Items. Okay, so we have some kind of array, and here what I'm doing, okay, I'm returning. So what we have here is, what I'm doing is actually checking if we don't have items, I'm returning an empty array, and if we have an array, I'm returning the items themselves. What I could do here is return null, okay, or simply return like this. But what I would cause if I do something like this is creating a logic that has to check whether the returned items are null or not. So let's create another example. Okay, export function get item mapper. Okay, and if not mapper, return item to item. Otherwise, return mapper. Okay, and mapper will be a function. Okay, so if we have a mapper initialized, I'm returning it. Otherwise, if we don't have it, I'm returning a default item mapper instead of returning null. So how would the code that uses those both functions would look like without null checks? I will need something like this. Item, I don't know, items one, because I already have items above. So let's call it items one, get items. Let's mapper one, get mapper, get a mapper, and items dot map and mapper. Okay, mapper one. And what's doing here? Okay, I don't really care about this. Okay, so what I'm having here is I'm getting an items array, and I'm having a mapper, and I'm using the mapper that I got from the getItems mapper on the items. But if we'd allow returning nulls, what I'd had to do is something like this. I'd had to check if the items exist and the mapper exist. Only then I would allow myself to run the mapper on the items. And this check is very easily to forget. So instead of doing this, instead of returning nulls, what I can do, I can avoid returning nulls where I can avoid it. So for example here, if the items are null, it is very reasonably to return an empty array, and for a mapper, if the mapper is not initialized, it is also, I think in most cases, will be reasonable to return a mapper that maps an item to itself. And this way, if we write code like this, it will be shorter, it will avoid if logics, and it will avoid unnecessary bugs when we forget checking for nulls or undefined. You have watched an episode about how to avoid unnecessary errors. Let me know what you think about it by leaving a comment in the comment section down below. You can watch more programming tips videos by clicking over here, or you can trust YouTube to know what you really want to see and click over here. If you want to watch more code related videos, check out my channel and feel free to subscribe. See you later on Program Artist.